Mr. President had put in place, accept it in good faith, and Nigeria will move forward.
Similarly, the arrival of the President-elect General Muhammadu Buhari at his polling unit in Daura was heralded with excitement by the crowd of voters at the center. As on March 28, the program of the card reader was without hitches, and within minutes, General Buhari's accreditation was done. When he returned for voting, accompanied by his wife Aisha, the process was equally seamless. The President-elect later held a press conference where he highlighted issues on economy and development plans.
Continues to grow in a sustainable way. I think worse still is the lack of accountability and the terrible budgeting system. He mentioned that over 90% of Nigerian budget is all recurrent. How can you sustain development in a developing country like Nigeria with only about 10% of your income? Things just have to change.
The Vice President-elect, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, and his family also voted without hitches in Lagos.
The elections started off with a lot of divisive type of politicking, people trying to divide us on the basis of religion, on the basis of ethnicity, and all of those kinds of divisive things. But I think in the end, Nigerians, by and large, came together to say no to all of that and to focus on what is key, which is good governance and the desire of everyone to live a decent existence.
Yes, also wanting
to elect those who they think will be able to provide that kind of a distance for themselves and for their children.
He also solicited for the support and cooperation of all Nigerians to enable them succeed. Voting started on schedule at major centers in Enugu and its environs. Chiegeono Aro reports.
Voting commenced as expected at Ugbo Okonkwo Voting Center. Four polling units were busy as voters lined up for voting and the INEC ad hoc staff helping out to ensure proper handling of voting sheets. At St. Mulumba Primary School, New Haven, the turnout was relatively large while the voting process went on smoothly. Some voters spoke to NTA News.
We start casting our votes and I have done my own now.
We are queuing very gently. No push me, I push you.
Sir Michael Opara Square was far from its usual large crowd, but voting was in progress. Some voters spoke to NTA News on their expectations.
The turnout was poor, but the democratic process was okay.
I'm impressed with the procedure, but I must confess that the turnout is very, very low. Unlike the presidential, the turnout is very low. And I believe that the people here, you know, they understood that democracy belongs to the people.
Some notable Nigerians who met the news crew in the field also spoke on their expectations.
It's peaceful, it's normal, but I'm a bit worried that there's a low turnout. It was not as vibrant as it was last week.
Important. Our expectations are that people are going to vote people who are credible, and people who are voting for somebody to come and serve them.
It is the view of the electorate that whoever becomes elected should carry the masses along. In Enugu, Chiegeonu Aro.
And in Oyo State, report says voting process commenced without hitches. Kemi Akinwande reports.
Areas visited in Ibadan North local government area include Agodi Bodijan University of Ibadan. Voting in the areas was conducted in a peaceful atmosphere with an increase in number of voters observed.
I think it's an improvement upon what was, you know, 4 years ago.
Voters, everybody behave themselves, and the INEC officials, they're doing very well.
If all the voting had gone as it has gone in my own polling booth, I would say the INEC will have scored a distinction.
We've seen the level of maturity from people.
At Unit 17B, Ward 11 of Abadina area in the University of Ibadan, 197 were accredited. 170 have been able to cast their vote. At the moment, the INEC ad hoc officials are waiting for the remaining accredited voters to show up and cast their vote. Others also comment on the voting process attributing the success to the use of the card reader.
There's never in a polling station that the card reader has never done well.
The card reader worked. It worked very well. We used it.
The electorate who have cast their votes waited patiently around for voting to end and witness counting. In Ibadan, Kemi Akinwande, NTA News.
Everywhere in the world, the strength of a woman cannot be underestimated. Recently, women began to find their way to the top politically, and in Nigeria, the trend is also rising. Adebola Brooklyn Sunday takes a look at the gender of candidates in the April elections across the country.
In 2011, the National Population Commission says about 83 million of approximately 168 million Nigerians are women, which forms about 49.4% of the country's population and about 18.6% of the population of women in Africa. A total of 760 candidates are contesting in the governorship elections in 29 states of the Federation, and few of them are women. Likewise, 5,290 candidates are contesting for seats in the various states' House of Assemblies nationwide. Some Nigerian women are of the opinion that, in spite of the growing trend, more women need to find their way to the peak of leadership, as a truly equal world will be one where women run half of the world and men run half of the homes.
We have women who are well talented, who are fit and ready to contribute to the system and improve things, but they are not being empowered.
Women should be given more opportunity to participate into the election.
I believe you know that our place in the past was in the kitchen. God save Mariam Babangida, who brought us out. So believe you me, we are better off today than yesterday.
Inasmuch as some of the women are willing to contest, there are factors militating against their will.
The funding, despite Electoral Act, our constitution, outcry is still too high and it is unacceptable. We must bring it down.
How many of these major political parties have actually said that we are taking a female candidate and then they stand by her and then they support her?
These factors, some women say, cannot stop them, as they will continue to strive until they achieve their goal of ruling the entire nation.
Even though we don't have the money to compete favorably with the men, but let me tell you, in a few years to come, money will not have any account in politically.
We want to see President Buhari coming on board and even increasing the strength of women in his government.
The nation moves forward with half, 50% of its population consigned to the backbench. It's no nation moves forward that way. And you know that the women constitute about 50% of this population. We can't afford to be consigned to the backbench.
The deduction is that women will continue to navigate the difficult times and come out with greater strength, as fortune does not favor the bold if they don't try. They will never know what they are capable of. In Abuja, Adebola Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
As Nigerians across 29 states of the country queue at various polling units to vote candidates of their choice, correspondent Adebola Brooklyn Sunday went round Abuja metropolis to take a look at what people are queuing for.
Eligible voters are battling to cast their ballots. Voters will have to queue, get accredited, and then vote.
Verification passed.
Okay.
The scenario is similar at the NNPC mega station, where customers on queue one after another takes their turn to purchase the products.
That after
Agu Kelechi says he has been on the queue for over 1 hour.
One is still baffled with this kind of situation. However, we don't know. Probably after the election period, things will relax.
Ifeoma Odigele is one of the few that keyed into the saying that all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
I'm telling old stories, something from your village, all those kind of things. Just stories that make you happy, you know? When you laugh, it's okay. Smiling is the best thing in life.
Despite the non-restriction on movements, traders in the popular Wuse market say they are experiencing low patronage, especially those selling food items.
They are not buying anything. And another thing, you know, see tire buy. They say no motor and fuel, they cost. They say no motor to buy things come inside town, yeah.
This is as we think. Most of the people that you see in the market are people that are sales. As today is a gubernatorial election, there's no election in Abuja. But people are, we didn't see people with no customers.
For the smooth conduct of the election, the federal government ordered the closure of borders and restriction of movement.
Just as a scholar say, it is not just enough to get busy. So are ants. The question is, what are we busy about? While some here are on queue to buy petrol, others queued to vote. Well, different strokes for different folks. In Abuja, Adebola Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
Still talking election mood, correspondent Ayena Yeyi Auta also went round Abuja City and brought back this report.
A drive around the capital city reveals that residents are going about their normal weekend and business activities undisturbed.
This is the popular and ever busy Area 1 roundabout. But today the case is different. We have scanty vehicular and human movement. Let's find out from the people why this is so.
Actually, today is a Saturday. And things that are going on in the country, most of people travel for their elections. So that's why you see here is scanty somehow. And some of them are at home doing some domestic work.
People went home for election, and that is why the place is so scanty. Everybody loves his area, that is area council. That is why they want to go and support the area council.
Out of curiosity to capture the mood of the city, and to know what the Federal Capital Territory Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, is doing on a day like this.
No election in FCT, but for other states, 29 states are having elections, governorship and state also assembly. In the FCT, everybody going about his own business. Our people in the states, to please conduct themselves properly. They should not do anything that is against the law. And if they do that, things will go on well. They should comply with the rules and regulations of the elections.
At Garki Area 1 and 2, and Wuse Zone 6 and 7, Market Area and Bega Roundabout, some Abuja residents expressed their feelings for not being a part of the elections.
I'm not quickly happy because I supposed to travel to my state and go and vote. But the one thing is, I got my PVC in Abuja here. 2019, I will try and vote for my state. And for my state, Gangan Enugu state, they called me that, yeah, they have peaceful election there. There's no classic, that they're just finished eating now. They want to come vote. That's okay, that's no problem. Besides, I tell them to stay from trouble, sir.
Why I didn't go to my state and cast my votes is because I don't have, my PBC is in Abuja here. I've collected my PBC here. And there is no way you can go to another state with your PBC and cast any bot. So I feel very happy. And I also called my people there in my state. What they are saying is that the election is going in a very peaceful manner.
Security operatives were seen at strategic locations doing their normal patrol in Abuja. Ayena Jeyi Auta, NTA News.
This is the news on NTA International, reaching you from Abuja, Nigeria. More reports after this time out.
Developments on the African continent.
Welcome to NTA International News. State House correspondent Hamza Musa.
In-depth news analysis and professional perspectives on all sides of the story.
Experts say the issue of natural energies and resources must be
mobilized to promote mass.
Every day on NTA International, we take you inside Africa and the world.
NTA International News, Africa as it is.
Most of their relatives back home are participating in the election, but as a result of their geographical relocation to Abuja following Boko Haram fallout, internally displaced persons did not participate. Musa Baba Aliyu tells us why.
There are over 1,000 eligible voters living in this internally displaced persons camp located at New Kuchigoro along National Stadium, Abuja. While elections are ongoing in their respective states, they were unable to participate due to the situation they find themselves. Most of them are indigents of Borno, Adamawa, Yobe and Kaduna states. While they await the outcome of the election, they hope that the process will be peaceful.
Nobody is happy to live here. When we are free, that there is no more crisis, everybody can go back there, because nobody will be happy to stay in this kind of a place. I am not happy because I have to vote for my rights.
They are not doing it here today. I was there. I even keep my card. Otherwise, I should have shown you here. I keep it at home now before I come to this area.
And you went there. They are not there.
They are not there. Nobody was there.
National Electoral Commission INEC says provision was only made for internally displaced persons in their respective states, as no election taking place in Abuja. As such, they forfeit that right. The displaced persons were, however, engaged by NGOs and religious bodies who were in the camp to extend hands of fellowship to them.
Here today, we've prayed that they will be reunited with their families and God will cause peace to reign all over Nigeria, and these people will go back to meet and stay with their family in peace and, you know, enjoy a normal life as it was before.
With positive development on the security situation in the Northeast, the displaced persons are hoping to return to their communities soon. In Abuja, Musa Baba Aliyu, NTA News.
As the process leading to the emergence of new chief executives across 29 states, as well as lawmakers across the 36 states House of Assembly continue, analysts have continued to speak on their expectations from the electoral process. Saliu Abdullahi, who spoke with some of the analysts shortly after their appearance on the live studio discussions Nigeria Decides on network service of the NTA.
The long-awaited April 11 is here. In a couple of hours, nothing less is expected than the outcome of voters' choice on the kind of executive and legislators they want for their respective states. Some of the analysts says the Independent National Electoral Commission has distinguished itself by providing a platform for Nigerians to achieve their desired leaders in a free and fair manner.
Even more significantly, it appears that today INEC officials and materials appeared at the polling stations and centers quite early.
Because INEC has been able to work assiduously in order to rectify those problems that were experienced with the, you know, smart card reader.
Patience and tolerance, they observed, should be an important ingredient that should be emulated by all in receiving the outcome of elections, and call on Nigerians to see politics as a social activity in building a stronger nation.
All in all, I expect that the process will be peaceful because the president has already set that tone of accepting or conceding to the...
And to avoid offenses that may bring them in conflict with the law.
There will be elections that they will be peaceful and they will be orderly. Even if they have a point to make, they'll make the point but in a peaceful manner.
Although reports from some parts of the country indicate slow pickup with low attendance of voters in the election where they are expected to elect leaders closer to them. The peaceful manner at which the exercise is being conducted in most parts of the country, the analyst says, is commendable. In Abuja, Salihu Abdullahi, NTA News.
And in Lagos, the European Union Observation Mission expressed concern over the low turnout of the electorate in some polling units visited in the state. Our correspondent caught up with the head of the observation mission while monitoring the exercise. The report.
I am here to observe, and also a very important thing, the collation, that is a very important point at the end of the day.
That was Santiago Fisas, chief observer of the EU Observer Mission. However, the few eligible voters who turned up to be accredited expressed their opinion this way.
Card reader worked, you know, very well, you know, and there isn't any problem. But, you know, I'm not really very happy because the voter turnout is extremely low.
There's no problem. Everything went smoothly. There is a low turnout. And I myself, I am surprised to see low turnout people for today.
But the foreign observers expressed the hope that the turnout may be more impressive at other polling units.
Turnout is not very high here, but also it's a good news that the card readers are performing very well. Only two problems, but of course it's not possible to take conclusions about what is happening on the rest of Lagos and even more in all the country.
That report from Lagos rounds up the news. Thanks for watching. I'm Taiwo Odubesan.
Nigeria needs peace and stability. Achieve our goals in unity. We are brothers and sisters, we've lived together for years now. Say no to violence now. Sing it with me.
Peace, peace, peace. Let's all embrace.